Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Thanksgiving is tomorrow, and you know what's immediately after that, those amazing days when all types of amazing items are on sale. That's right, Black Friday and Cyber Monday are almost here. Today, we've got you covered with helpful tips for shopping during these hectic times. Please welcome our friend and lifestyle expert, Satchel Jester, to the show.
Hey, how you doing? Hey. How you doing? Good.
Oh, I'm doing very well. How about you?
Good to be back.
Are you good?
I'm ready to drink and celebrate and, you know, be thankful and more thankful.
Right. Thanksgiving is actually one of my, it is my most favorite holiday because it's just about eating, drinking, and being around people you love.
Those
are the, like, three of my favorite things to
do.
That's it.
Families. Yeah.
But people really are like going to be at the shopping plazas like tomorrow night with this whole thing.
It's a whole thing. That doesn't have to be a thing.
And you're going to help us not make it a whole thing. What's your first tip?
My first tip would be to familiarize yourself with restrictions.
Okay.
So in retailing and shopping, just like anything else, there has to be a method to the madness.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to be clear on what you're going after. Like, research the stores before you go, because a lot of times there are quantity restrictions. Sometimes you can only get it in store. Sometimes you can buy it online. So you have to go beneath the headlines to really make sure that you understand what you need to do to get the sales that you think you see.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
It's just so much research.
For sure.
It's shop.
It's all about research.
Yeah.
All about research.
Okay.
Yeah.
So what's the next tip that we need?
Get social. So we know that social media is the epicenter of everything in life right now, like it or not.
Mm-hmm.
And it's the same thing for shopping. A lot of brands and retailers, they reward their loyal consumers and customers through social media.
Yeah.
So they go to their Facebook pages, their Twitter feeds, their Instagram pages. They offer additional discounts, additional codes. If you're registered to receive text messages, they send you a click-through coupon. So if social media is a part of your life, use it for your good to spend less money when you're shopping.
I know. Yeah. I love Fashion Nova. Yeah. I get all they text messages.
Fashion Nova is, okay, 70% off and buy one, get one.
Right.
Okay,
so it's
is.
A whole lot. So
there
what about people with, you know, that just don't like the crowds? I'm not a crowd person. What advice do you have for those folks who don't like the crowds?
My advice is don't get arrested for fighting in Walmart.
Yes.
Shop at home. Like, literally, you can avoid packing the tents, pulling out the lawn chairs, calling your homeboys, your homegirls, and camping out overnight. Go to your computer.
Yeah.
Go to the site. You have a better chance of getting the things that you really, really want, because all you have to do is load it into your cart.
Yeah.
9 times out of 10, you're not going to find the stuff in the store anyway, because they hide it. They rearrange the store. So if you're in the comfort of your own home, get it, drop it, click it, sit back, drink some champagne.
Right.
You know what I mean?
I would like that.
Yeah.
Watching college football on Friday.
Yeah.
And just do that.
And the other thing is, skip the doorbusters.
Mm-hmm.
Don't believe the hype. As much as a store would love to give everybody a 90-inch television for $19.99,
mm-hmm.
it doesn't happen that way.
Okay.
There may be 5 in the store, and there are 800 people outside waiting on the same thing. You don't stand a chance.
Right.
So doorbusters, that's just the bait to pull you in. And
so
then
they want to get you in.
Absolutely.
They only have 8 available.
Yeah.
So they get you in so that you can shop
for
other stuff.
For sure. And then you're fighting. You know what I mean? Like, we see those fights on TV.
It's awful.
That's Black Eye Friday.
Yes.
Not Black Friday. Okay.
What about those brands that barely go on sale, though? I mean, should we even try to camp out and look for those types of things, or will they never go on sale?
Yes and no.
Okay.
I mean, we don't see the word sale in the windows of our favorite luxury boutiques.
Mm-hmm.
But some of the bigger retailers that carry them, the Nordstrom, Saks, Macy's, they have sales. They have loyalty rewards. They have frequent buyer programs. So you can still get those items on sale, just not from some of the boutiques.
Yeah.
Again, do your research. Study what's there.
Oh, my God. It seems like so much.
Okay.
So how do we, like, avoid over shopping? Because some people don't. Some people that I know who have on a green dress and some brown shoes don't really write stuff down when they go shopping, and then you end up doing too much.
Well, some people, like my friend in the green dress, like, you can probably afford to stray away from the list.
Mm-hmm.
But other people need to stick to the script.
Well, not really.
Okay.
No, I'm just kidding.
Stick to the script.
Yeah, yeah.
Identify what you need. How many you need? It's just like planning a wedding. There's always more alternatives, but stick to what you really need and just go by the list. Don't overspend. Make sure you study and literally just get what you need.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What about
coupons?
Are you into? Because my husband, we got like a whole bunch of like papers in the mail yesterday, and he automatically recycles them, and we never really look through it.
Yeah.
Do
yeah.
you believe in the whole coupon thing when it comes to Black Friday?
I do, especially when it's holiday time.
Yeah.
Like, a lot of times people don't want to go through the process of clipping the coupons, reading, I'm reading the paper. That's very like 1978. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So we don't want to deal with it, but they're literally trying to give some stuff away. So yeah. Coupons still work, especially for Black Friday. You even get coupons that you can apply to Cyber Monday. Again, those codes that we talked about from social or those text messages, it's all still there. Coupons are a real thing.
So from your research, how different is shopping online for Black Friday as opposed to Cyber Monday? I know that's a little off script, but in your research and what you found, is that
is there
a big difference?
Well, it's all a part of the same machine.
Okay.
Essentially. What a lot of people don't know is that retailers aren't required to go to their lowest holiday price until December 25th. So, and technically, Black Friday started last Sunday. Mm-hmm. So Black Friday sales have been going from Sunday to now. So it's still, you know, it may be 30% off now, and it may go to 40% off Christmas Eve. So it's all just broken down to give us some pomp and circumstance to the shopping season.
Yeah.
But it's the same stuff, the same prices, and you really have to watch. Oh, unless you see something you absolutely have to have and you can't wait.
Apps and websites that we need.
BlackFriday.com, BestBlackFriday.com, DealNews.com. And again, just do your research on the sites of the brands. A lot of stuff is there that you would not know was there unless you go look.
Wow, this is great. Satchel, thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
I'm always so proud of you for your ascension and entertainment and what you're continuing to do. You know I love you very much.
I appreciate
it. Please make sure you follow him. Seen by Satchel on Instagram. I follow him. He has a great page.